everybody and welcome on my YouTube channel. You are with Alandris for today's 10th episode of Pimp My Hero Charge. And today we will have four players who will be pimped. The first player is El Troubadour level 80. The second player is GamerGuy level 95. Third player Igorko level 98. And last player is Tui level 98. Let's begin now by the heroes of El Troubadour. For our first player today, El Troubadour is level 80, and for sure it's not really high level, so the main task that I will try to do today is to give him the way to follow for the future. I will for sure give him the arena team and the grand arena team, but it's not the main problem actually. Let's begin now by the arena team. For your arena team, first things that I can tell you, it's I'm not an expert of the metagame level 80, so I hope what I propose will work, but I'm not sure. So first team for arena is Warchief. It was really good tank as your level, so I hope he's still active. Amberblade behind him to deal a good amount of overall damage. Deathmatch for the same reason as a magic damage dealer. You have in the backline Commando to protect your backline and Imperial Executioner to kill an eventual ninja that you can meet at this level and to deal a good amount of damage. Let's now see your team for Grand Arena. For your Grand Arena, I propose you three setups. So, first setup, it's mix more oriented physical damage than magical damage, but you have Warchief plus Amberblade. In the middle you have Magical Touch and Silence with Deathmage. Behind you have Commando to boost them at the beginning of the fight, and Leaf Shadow, so you give a big bonus of agility for Amberblade, who will I hope deal enough damage to kill the enemy. Second team, it's a magical team. At this level, you can do some team really efficient. So you have Dwarf Warrior as tank, and behind you have four magical, hard magical DPS with Frost Mage who removes the magical resistance for the target, the Blind of Machinist, and the Ice of All Curse. So this team more or less can have a good result if I remember good at this level. And your last team is the Commander as a tank. I didn't find something else to put. You have behind Corrupted Angel, Claude Walker, Ninja that I hate to put in a defensive setup, but in this case we don't have so much choice, and Vengeance Spirit for the overall damage. It's three team, I did my best, I will tell you the truth, but I'm not sure about the result, so I'm interested about your return about these teams. So, let's see now what I can advise you for the future. For the future, I will not hide that you have a lot of work in front of you. First of all, you need to increase some tank. You actually need at least two tanks in your setup, so you can increase the Dwarf Warrior, for example, that you have begin. I have the question that where is the Turtle Fighter, but perhaps you are in the new server where it's not possible to have a Turtle Fighter, so it's one possibility, but if he is there, you need to increase him for sure, and if not, you can continue to upgrade Admiral for a while for the moment. It will be better than nothing, because you can't play without tank, it's just impossible. Second advice, and it's really important, you don't have so much hero and you don't have so much resources, so you mustn't waste resources in some hero who are totally useless actually. I saw that you have a Poison 1 and a Savage 1 Red 2. Even if Red 2 is not amazing, for you for the moment it looks like to be a lot of resources, and these hero are horrible. You can forget them for the moment, you could upgrade them later if you really want them, but for the moment better to upgrade. For example, when I watch in your hero, you have a Devastator, Soul Hunter who are really good, you have a Cleric who is really good, why not Lightbringer, even if before level 90 is not so amazing. You have some possibility other than this crap, and it will give a better lineup for you. Prepare the future, like I told you, you have a Coated Angel 3 stars, but you can invest on him already, it's an amazing damage dealer, and in the future he will continue to be amazing for you. And the last thing that I can tell you, actually for all the heroes that you have, if we are watching about the, how to tell, the metagame hero, actual metagame hero in high level, you nearly don't have them. So watch out the other pims that I did, for example, and it can give you an idea of the important hero that you have to invest right now. I wish you really good luck for the future. Bye bye, and let's now continue with the second player. Second player for today is Gamer Guy. He's level 95. He has good choice of hero, more or less, not so much choice, but the heroes that he increase are not bad, and I will see what I can prepare for him, and let's begin by the arena. For the arena team, let's begin by one team that I like really much. It's a one timeout team. At your level, it will be really efficient, especially with the heroes that you have. So you have the combination Turtle Fighter, Dwarf Warrior, Cleric and Soul Hunter who are really soaked. And behind you have Chemist who give a good control, who protect your backline and stun, mind control, and even can replace one tank when you will use his ultimate when the fight will already begin. So this team is really interesting. I used it long time during long time in arena sometimes ago. I changed a while now, but you will have a good result, I'm sure of that, with this team. Let's check now your Grand Arena. Your Grand Arena, three really interesting setup. So first setup, you have Dwarf Warrior with Fallen Dominion behind, will be able to protect your backline, with kind of weak at the moment. You have Rose Fencer to control the woman and even to deal a good amount of damage. Desert Licorn for his ultimate and also for some damage during the fight were not so bad. And Silencer to give you a really good control and to delay the enemy team with his burning of energy. Second team, this team is amazing, I can promise to you, because it's the same team that I use in Grand Arena in the same position, and this team you can also use it in a Grand tournament with your guild, because it's one team really soaked who is able to kill at equal level 3, 4, 5 other teams, even sometimes more when you are lucky. So you have a Turtle Fighter, Cleric and Soul Hunter who are really soaked. Behind you have Imperial Executioner to nuke the eventual Turtle Fighter enemy or to nuke the frontline tank, because it's not a problem. And Sorceress behind, the Imperial Executioner will protect her as well. She will receive the heal most of the time from the Cleric and from Soul Hunter, because at the beginning of the fight she's out of the range of Soul Hunter heal, but when she will push the front line, she will go in front and she will begin to be healed by Soul Hunter. This team is really amazing, it's a guarantee 100%. And your last team, in my meaning, it's the weakest in your setup, because in front, okay, you have a good tank, good combo of tank of tank. Behind, Deathmatch to deal the damage and Manipulator to control the battleground. But I don't like to have a Queen of Curse in the backline. It's little random hero, and I prefer to have another backliner, like I will advise you for your future, and it's right now. Like I told in the introduction, your setup is pretty interesting. It's just some detail that you need to improve. And first one is the most important. Please listen to me. You have to increase some backliner. Actually, when I want to put something in the backline, I don't have any solution. No Lightbringer, no Puppet Master, no Witch. it's some hero who are really important, especially if enemy want to use sapper, want to use ninja. You will be able to rape them totally quickly, and they can't use absolutely ninja or sapper if you use this hero in your backline. So please upgrade at least one of them. I advise you Witch in first time because she's amazing. I have her at red 2 and her damage are just without sense. For example, if a sapper go to her when she has ultimate, he receive 45k damage and instant die. So it's just an example. It's one of the things that I want to advise you, and after that you can continue to upgrade Corrupted Angel. I saw that you begin him and it's really good. And also Griffin, who is actually in your lineup but really low, you can upgrade these two heroes. It will be a good investment for the future. Nothing to add, it will be already a good task because your heroes are pretty far, so you need some time to upgrade them. You have the basic lineup who is interesting, I repeat for you. So continue like that, and let's check now our third player of the day. Our third player of the day is Igor Ko, he's level 98, and we can see here the list of heroes that he has in his possession. And the problem, main problem for me, he doesn't have so much heroes who are full upgraded, and some important heroes are missing. We will see all of this. Let's begin by the arena. Here is your lineup for Arena. Like you see, it's an interesting lineup with Turtle Fighter, with Griffin in front, who will deal important amount of damage. You have Rose Fencer to give control. You have Impel Executioner to nuke the enemy Turtle Fighter, and your backline is protect by Witch. So this setup is interesting, even if Witch is not so efficient against Turtle Fighter. Normally you will be able to kill the enemy Turtle Fighter quickly, and Witch after that will have all the way to deal important amount of damage. She also has blind, who is really useful against physical composition actually. Let's see now your Grand Arena. For your Grand Arena, first of all, I want to tell you that you don't have enough hero to do three interesting lineup. So I did what I could. First lineup is first team is interesting with Dwarf Warrior, Soul Hunter, Commander, and behind you have Hidden Needle and Manipulator. All these heroes are sweet good together. Commander with Soul with Hidden Needle and Manipulator. Soul Hunter will heal the four heroes of the line. Dwarf Warrior will hold the front line for sure, and Manipulator to mess the battleground. Second team is your team of Arena, so nothing to add. And your last team, unfortunately, is really low, so you have the opportunity, for example, to put this team in first position and to hide your good team in the third position. You will see how it's going on. Admiral with Shadow Leaf to have more life for Shadow Leaf and to protect your backline. I choose 4 agility hero to get the bonus of Shadow Leaf, but I'm not full of confidence for this team, to be honest. So let's see how it's going on, and let's see which advice I can give you for the future. So for your future, some hard work in front of you. First of all, you must increase your tank. Actually, you have only Turtle Fighter, if we can tell as tank, because your other tank are orange too. It's like if they are not here, it's exactly the same. So you have to increase Dwarf Warrior in priority. It's already legendary, so it's a good point. After that, Cross Knight is far, but it's a good investment, better than Admiral that you have as red and who will be unfortunately nearly useless actually anyway. After that, you have middle hero who are not bad, so you can continue with this hero and even increase some magical hero because you don't have so much of them. And please increase your backliner, Witch Orange 2. It's nearly useless. You need to have her red and red 1. She's amazing backliner. I tell it in every Pimp episode. And people doesn't listen to me. It's not possible. The same, Lightbringer must be increased. You have him already legendary. Another good point. But now you must stuff him. And why not to put Puppet Master? I didn't see him in your lineup. And it's for sure a good backliner. It's already a big job to do this. Increase even Soul Hunter, because it's a good support, like you saw. If you watch my channel, it's one of the best support in the game, and you must have him in your lineup. When you will have done already this, it will be a big step forward. So continue, good luck. Last player for today is Tui. He's level 98, and we can tell that he has in his possession a really good lineup, and we will see now what we can do for him. Let's begin by the arena. For your arena, I propose you one timeout team. The timeout that I like. Okay, you have not Chimist behind, but you have the really soaked combo with 4 hero, Turtle Fighter, Dwarf Warrior, Cleric, and Soul Hunter. And behind this, you have Rose Fencer, who is not bad. Not so good in my thinking than Chimist in this position, but it's really efficient setup. Let's see now in Grand Arena. For your Grand Arena here, three lineups. So first of all, you have with Admiral, it's the lineup that I like the less, but it can be useful. So you have Admiral with a Griffin, Desert Lycan, Queen of Curse, and Commando. So it gives a boost at the beginning of the fight. You get one free round of energy, which will be really useful for Desert Lycan and Griffin, at least for Queen of Curse. Queen of Curse will remove the armor for the target, so it will give you even more damage. Commando is here just to protect your backline, and the rest is here for damage. It's physical damage most of the team. Second team, it's one standard. It's a little dangerous against Rose Fencer, but for the rest it will be really efficient. Your backline is protected by Imperial Executioner. You have Manipulator to mess the battlefield. Deathmage for the silence and the overall damage. Commander, who will give the bonus life for the woman and at least some good damage in position of tank. And Turtle Fighter, like we know, who is really good. Your last team is with Dwarf Warrior, Soul Hunter, Fallen Dominion, and Rose Fencer. We'll receive all heal for Soul Hunter. At least I think Demon Assassin will receive it. I see a Demon Assassin is upgraded at max level. That's why I put her there. Her damage output are really interesting. And if she succeeds to survive till her ultimate, her damage are really insane. It's all for now. Let's see my advice for your future. For your future, in according to your actual lineup, you don't have so much things to do to be really good. So continue to upgrade Cleric and Chimist. It's a really important heroes. You can upgrade Legendary Lightbringer, because actually it's not done, and even to upgrade his stuff, it will be a plus. After that, you can upgrade Silencer. It's a really nice support when you begin to be red 1 and even red 2 for the future. It's not for tomorrow for you, but you can think about it already. As tank, you have Death Knight with orange. It's not emergency, but you can begin to think about him for the future, because with his legendary skill with unlock, he will begin, I'm sure of that, one key of the future metagame. It's all for now. This episode is finished for today. Let's now conclude. This 10th episode of Pimp is over for today. Thank you guys for watching. You can like the video if you like it and subscribe for my channel. Don't forget to upgrade your backliner and your tank for the future, for everyone who want to ask me Pimp for the future. Thank you another time. Bye bye.